नमो ब्रह्मादिभ्यो ब्रह्म विद्या संप्रदाय कर्तृभ्यो वंश ऋषिभ्यो महद्भ्यो नमो गुरुभ्यः सर्वोपप्लवरेतः प्रज्ञान घन प्रत्यकर्तो ब्रह्मैवाहमस्मि ब्रह्मैवाहमस्मि नारायणं पद्मभूम वसिष्ठं शक्तिं च तत्पुत्र पराशरं च व्यासं शुकं गौड़पदं महांतं गोविंद योगींद्रमथास्य शिष्यं श्रीशंकराचार्यमथास्य पद्मपादं च हस्तामलकं च शिष्यं तंतोटकम वार्तिकमस्मदुरू सततमानतोस्मि श्रुतिस्मृतिप्राणानामालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः सहनावतु सहनं भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः यद्ब्रह्म गोचर विचित्रतमः प्रभावात् संसारधीजनदुःखमभूज्जनस्य यद्ब्रह्मधीजनितसौख्यमभूच्च तस्य तं रुक्मिणीसहितकृष्णमहं नमामि यमिह कारुणिकं शरणं गतोऽप्यरि सहोदरापमहत्पदं तमहमाशु हरिं परमाश्रये जनकचाङ्कमनन्तसुखाकृतिम्। बिफोर वी बिगिन लेट्स सम अप द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ अध्यासास मेंशन्ड डिफरेंट टाइप्स इन द सेंस In the context of adhyasa, what are the words which were used? As a recap, before we move further. So adhyasas, initially there was a talk of dharmi adhyasa and dharma adhyasa. So dharmi adhyasa is the atma and anatma. In the case of the adhyasa bhashya, atma and anatma. Yushmat pratyaya gochara, anatma, jada. And is a dharmi which dharmas jadadi dharmas the jada padartha has jadatva etc those kind of dharmas and on the part of asmat pratyaya gochara which is atma has dharmas which are sachidananda dharmas and they are tamah tamah prakashavat viruddha swabhava both have opposing dharmas also and therefore there cannot be dharmi adhyasa and there cannot be dharma adhyasa in that context we saw dharmi adhyasa and dharma adhyasa so dharma adhyasa is taking each other's dharmas vyatyasena which do not belong so dharmi tadatmya sambandha or aikya is not possible and dharmas across cannot be there व्यत्यासेना इन दी धर्मी सो दीज टू अध्यासाज वेर मेंशन्ड देन विथ अयम लोक व्यवहारा नैसर्गिको अयम लोक व्यवहारा इन दैट कॉन्टेक्स्ट वी सॉ लोक मीन्स अर्थाध्यासा एंड बाय कर्मणि व्युत्पत्ति लोक्यते अध्यस्यते इति अर्थाध्यासा एंड देन ज्ञानाध्यास वी सॉ द मीनिंग ऑफ व्यवहार बाय व्यवहरणम व्यवहार बाय भावे व्युत्पत्ति वेर अध्यसनम व्यवहरणम अध्यसनम अध्यास विच इज ज्ञानाध्यास इति ज्ञानाध्यास सो वी सॉ दीज टू टाइप्स ऑफ अध्यास एडिशनली इन धर्मी अध्यास धर्माध्यास इन दैट लिस्ट टू मोर गॉट एडेड एज अर्थाध्यास एंड ज्ञानाध्यास वॉट इज अर्थाध्यास द विषय अध्यास In the case of Rajju Sarpa, the Sarpa is the Vishaya and the Jnana related to Sarpa is also an Adhyasa. So Artha Adhyasa is the Sarpa, Vishaya, Adhyasa and Jnana Adhyasa is Sarpa, Jnana. Sarpa Jnana is also an Adhyasa. Then we saw the, in the last part we saw Tasya Anatmani Samsarga Matra Adhyasa na Swarupasya. So we saw two more words as to adhyasa swarupa adhyasa and samsarga adhyasa is tadatmya adhyasa identification as one rajju is identified as sarpa sarpa is identified as rajju Now, looking at the perspective difference, meaning from the side of the, from the perspective of the Rajju as well as from the perspective of the Sarpa, when you have a comparison, then Idam Swarupa, what is Adhyastha is Idam really of the Rajju Amsha. So the Idam Amsha of the Rajju is really existing, therefore there is no Swarupa Adhyasa of that Idam Amsha in Sarpa. However, Idam Amsha of Sarpa is not there at all, because Sarpa isn't there. How can there be Idam Amsha in the Sarpa? Whatever Idam Amsha is Pratita in Sarpa is the Idam Amsha of the Rajju itself, which exists really. So therefore there is no Swarupa Adhyasa of Rajju in Sarpa, or in the case of, we saw with the example of Shukti Rajata, but in any Adhyasa Stala it will be the same. However, Samsarga, the Tadatmya of the Rajju with the Sarpa and Sarpa with the Rajju, both sides if you look at it, there is no Samsarga possible, and therefore that Samsarga is an Adhyasa. Therefore, Swarupa Adhyasa is there in one case, meaning Swarupa of the Sarpa not being there, Swarupata Sarpa not being there, there is an Adhyasa on Rajju as well as Samsarga Adhyasa. Whereas from the perspective of the Rajju, the Rajju Idam Amsha in Sarpa, there is only Samsarga Adhyasa, Swarupa Adhyasa isn't there. Why? Because Idam Amsha is existing, which is basically in the exemplified in the Darshtantika, the Atma is Satyataha there, Swarupata Satyata, Atma is there, whereas Anatma Ahankara is Mithya. Therefore, there is no Swarupa Adhyasa of Atma in Anatma, whereas Anatma in Atma there is a Swarupa Adhyasa also, but in both cases there is a Samsarga Adhyasa. So these are the Dharmi Adhyasa, Dharma Adhyasa, Artha Adhyasa, Jnana Adhyasa, Swarupa Adhyasa and Samsarga Adhyasa or Tadatmya Adhyasa. These are the words we saw. Now, why did we look at the last two, Samsarga Adhyasa as well as Swarupa Adhyasa? There was a Purva Paksha to this, as to if Atma is Adhyastha in Anatma and Anatma is Adhyastha in Atma, then you have landed yourself into Shunyavada. So that was refuted by saying Swarupataha Atma is there, therefore Swarupa Adhyasa not being there, every other Adhyasa will be refuted, will be negated, will be sublated, but the Adhishthana Satta, Atma Satta will never go. Therefore, there will never be Shunyavada Prasanga. Now, let's look at more in this part. Huh? Continuing with Nanu. Okay, let's go to Tika first, because there is a statement, not an introductory statement. It is not a Sangati Tika, but there is something in the Tika where it is said, so tasmatna shunyavada prasanga iti bhava, shunyavada prasanga isn't there, that we saw in the last part. Nanu satyanrutayoho mithunikaranam katham vadinam asammatatvat. So how can there be mix up of satya and anruta? This is the objection of the purva pakshi. Why? Because not every vadi accepts it. Vadinam asammatatvat, there is no sammati of all vadis as to satya and Anruta gets mixed up. Mixed up as what? Mithunikaranam becomes one as though. Atra uchyate shruti pramanya idam siddhanta anusarana vibhavaniyam iti bhava. So the idea is that shruti pramana is there. We have shruti pramana, whether the other vadis have it in their own darshana is not our concern at all. Why? Because shruti pramana is there as to Satya and Anruta becomes mixed up. Further, we can also say it is Anubhava Siddha. Anubhava Siddha, we have seen Manushyam Ityadi. No Vadi, Astika Vadi, Astika Darshanika will say as to Manushyatvam is Atma Dharma. Nobody will agree with that. So it is not really Atma Dharma, it is a Sharira Dharma, Deha Dharma. However, there is an Adhyasa. Now, that Manushyatvam is itself satya, that may be the argument. So satya anruta mithuni karanam, there manushyatvam is satya and atma is satya, there is dharmadhyasa of manushyatvam on oneself, therefore it is not satya and anruta mithuni karanam. That may be an argument, which is the case here, and there we say that Shruti is a pramana there, because Shruti talks about ahankaradi as mithya. Where does it talk about it? All over the place. In each Upanishad, there is at least a little bit of adhyaropa section. Then there is an apavada section. Those who stop at adhyaropa as to the samsara creation, the creation of the world, etc., and don't go to the Upanishad proper, wherein there is no tatpari nishya as to apavada is being done, and the commitment is to show that there is no adhyaropa at all. This adhyaropa is talked about because we see this prapancha as satya, we see ahankaradi as satya, but by apavada what is shown is mithyatvam. So mithyatva nishchaya can be done only when the apavada process is understood. So in Taittiriya Upanishad, for example, Deha is talked about as Atma. The Annamaya is talked about as Atma. Then Anyantara Atma. Who is that? Pranamaya. So Pranamaya is Atma. Once Pranamaya is said to be Atma, the Apavada of Annamaya being Atma is being done. Therefore, Annamaya is reduced to Kosha and Pranamaya becomes Atma. Then Pranamaya is reduced to Kosha, Vijnanamaya, Manomaya becomes Atma, and so on and so forth, when there is no further koshatvam possible, because it is your very swarupa, and that is the satya atma, whereas every other kosha is mithya. Then back to the Ratna Prabha. Nanu adhyasa mithuni karana loka vyavahara shabdanam ekartatve अध्यस्य मिथुनीकृत्य इति पूर्वकालत्व वाचिक्त्वाप्रत्ययादेशस्य लेपकतम प्रयोगः इति चेत् न. सो नाउ देयर इज एन ऑब्जेक्शन लुकिंग एट द व्याकरण इन द भाष्य. लेप प्रत्यय हैज बीन यूज्ड इन द सेंटेंस एज टू अध्यस्य मिथुनीकृत्य एंड देन लोक व्यवहार. एंड व्हाट यू एक्सप्लेन इज द पूर्व पक्ष दिस लोक व्यवहार. व्हाट इज लोक व्यवहार? यू सेड लोक इज अर्थाध्यास एंड व्यवहार मीन्स ज्ञानाध्यास. ओके, व्हाट अबाउट मिथुनीकरण? मिथुनीकृत्य, व्हेन यू से मिथुनीकृत्य, हैविंग डन मिथुन मीनिंग हैविंग मिक्सड अप व्हाट आत्मा एंड अनात्मा. So what is that? That is also adhyasa. Okay, loka vyavahara, in that loka vyavahara, loka is adhyasa, vyavahara is adhyasa. Loka vyavahara is loka sahita vyavahara, therefore it is adhyasa. Mithuni karana is indicated, is the meaning given here as to having done mithuni karanam. Is what? Having done that mithuni krutya is the word usage there. What is krutya? It is ending with a मिथुनी कृ प्लस त्वा प्रत्यय. त्वा प्रत्यय वॉज एडेड, बट देन देर इज अ कंपाउंडिंग डन हियर, एंड दैट कंपाउंडिंग इज नॉट अ नन कंपाउंडिंग. देर फोर देर इज ल्यप आदेश. कंटेंट ऑफ ल्यप इज य. सो त्वा इज रिप्लेस्ड बाय ल्यप. इन वॉट सेंस? इन द सेम सेंस एज त्वा. देर फोर यू गॉट मिथुनी कृत्य. नाउ वॉट इज दिस Tva pratyaya, when is it used? It is used when the karta is same and the kriyas are different. So there is a difference here in kriyas as to the tva pratyaya or lya pratyaya usage. What is being done is that it should be used only when there is a difference in kriya. Now here, what is the difference? It is an adhyasa. So mithuni kritya, when you say mithuni kritya, then mithuni karana is an adhyasa, And loka vyavahara is also an adhyasa. Whereas in the, as an example, when is tva used, so snatva gachati. There tva is used. Let's say devadatta snatva gachati. Devadatta is a karta, same karta. When the kriya is different here and there is a purva kalatvam. What is a purva kalatvam here? There is snana kriya which is earlier and then gamana kriya which is later. So when Devadatta has a bath and having had a bath he goes. So the usage is what? Having had a bath Devadatta goes, travels, whatever. So when he's going out after bath, then only you should use tva pratyaya. You cannot say having done something, does something else when there is no purva parabhava. There is no difference in time as to the kriyas. Now, this adhyasya you have mentioned earlier. Adhyasya mithunikritya naisargiko ayam loka vyavaharaha. Whereas adhyasya, there also there is a lyap pratyaya. Mithunikritya lyap pratyaya. So there are two times you have used purva para bhavitvam in adhyasa and then adhyasa. Loka vyavara means adhyasa. So if I have to just replace it by meaning, what will it be? Adhyasya. There it is, adhyasya itself, having done adhyasa. Mithunikritya, again adhyasya, having done adhyasa. Loka vyavahara, meaning what? Adhyasa. So if I just replace by meaning, in the bhashya, what will it mean? Adhyasya, adhyasya, adhyasa. Adhyasya, adhyasya, adhyasanam. So what is this adhyasya, adhyasya, adhyasa? What kind of bhashya is this? Where is purva para bhava? Having done adhyasa, one does adhyasa. What kind of a sentence is this? Ask the purva pakshi. Where is the purva para bhava here? So everything is an adhyasa. So how can you say? How can you differentiate as to having done adhyasa, one does another adhyasa, and having done that adhyasa, one does adhyasa? That is the meaning. So nanu adhyasa mithuni karana loka vyavahara shabdanam ekarthatve sati. When there is a same meaning for all these three, adhyasa mithuni karana and loka vyavahara, which are known through adhyasya mithuni kritya and loka vyavahara, there adhyasya mithuni kritya iti purva kalatva vachi ktva pratyaya adeshasya. This ktva pratyaya adesha is lyap. So lyapaha of lyap, which is in the place of ktva, which itself is purva kala vachi. There is a purva para bhava. Katham prayogaha iti chet, how can that be used here? Iti chet na adhyasa vyakti bhedat. How so? Siddhanti says, I agree that the statement is adhyasya adhyasya. The meaning of the sentence is adhyasya adhyasya adhyasa. So adhyasya mithuni kritya loka vyavaharam definitely means adhyasya adhyasya adhyasa. But the contexts are different. All three contexts of adhyasa are different. Therefore, vyakti bheda is there. Like the bijankura nyaya. When you say bija is born from ankura, ankura is born from bija, which came first? None of these can be talked about as which came first. But when you say one bija has come from an ankura, so bija one came from ankura one, and bija came from ankura, when you say again, bija came from ankura, ankura came from bija. So bija 1 came from ankura 1. And just for to put in numbers, instead of putting numbers, let's just say bija n1. Or if you say bija n came from ankura n, because we don't want to put a number as 1, it is anadi. The sequence is there, but it is an anadi sequence. You cannot say which came first. Or you don't want to talk about a first bija or a first ankura. There is nothing called as first bija or first ankura. It has ever been there. Has the same bija been there? No. Bija n is subject to destruction. Ankura n is also subject to destruction. But still there is a parampara. There is a bija n plus 1 born from ankura. Bija n born from ankuras, let's say. And then ankura n. But then ankura n plus 1 is born from bija n. Then ankura n plus 1 gives rise to bija n plus 1. So bija n plus 1 is born from ankura n plus 1. And so on, n plus 2 from n plus 1. This is the parampara. So although if we say bija from ankura, ankura from bija, we don't mean the same bija and same ankura. Otherwise, there will be anyonya ashraya. There will be mutual dependency. Bija depends on ankura, ankura depends on bija. Yes, there is a dependency, but it is not the same bija and ankura. So the bija born from ankura and ankura born from bija, that when the second time when you say ankura is also born from bija, the sapling is born from the seed, there we do not mean that the seed which was born from ankura becomes the source for the same ankura. We mean a different ankura. And similarly here, when we talk about adhyasya, adhyasya, adhyasa, it's a different adhyasa. Vyakti bheda is there. First adhyasa that has been mentioned, adhyasya, that is a different adhyasa from mithuni krutya adhyasa, that adhyasya. And then loka vyavahara is also an adhyasa which is different from the earlier two. So there is a vyakti bheda. So the simple answer is what? Adhyasa vyakti bhedat na. Katham prayoga lepaha, that objection cannot be brought in because there is definitely a purva parabhavatvam. Adhyasa vyakti bheda. Tatra purva purva adhyasa purva purva adhyasasya tatra. How so? So explanation is given as to how is there is a vyakti bheda in adhyasas. Tatra purva purva adhyasasya uttara uttara adhyasam prati samskara dvara. Purvakalatvena. How is the Purvakala in the earlier adhyasa to the later adhyasa? So Purva Purva adhyasa. Each and every early adhyasa leaves a samskara for the Uttara Uttara adhyasa to take place. Meaning Purva adhyasa leaves a samskara and that samskara vasana leads to another adhyasa. That adhyasa leaves a phala as samskara, and that samskara gives rise to another adhyasa, and this is the anadi parampara. When was the first adhyasa? There was never a first adhyasa, there was always an adhyasa. Therefore this adhyasa parampara pravaha is nitya, it is anadi. Nitya in the sense anadi, pravaha nityatvam is there. Just like this prapancha was created, maya has to exist. So, does Maya exist as a second entity? No, Maya is also Mithya. Prapancha is Karya of Maya, that is also Mithya. Then which Prapancha is Mithya? Was Satya Yuga Prapancha Mithya as well? Yes, it was Mithya. What about Dwapara Yuga? That is also Mithya. Treta Yuga, Mithya. So, Treta, Dwapara and then Kali Yuga, all these Prapanchas are Mithya. Then after the Kalpa, again all this will start. So many Chaturyugas, so many Kalpas, what happened there? The Prapancha is still there. So Prapancha appears to be there. It was continued the way it was there in the earlier Kalpa. So there is Pravaha Nityatvam in Maya, Pravaha Nityatvam in Prapancha also. Similarly, Adhyasa here, Ahankara, Ahankara, Sukshma Sharira is always there. It was never born. But then, there are granthas which talk about how these came about, how did indriyas come about, how did prana come about, all these are mentioned. So what about that? Yeah, they are put together in the beginning of the kalpa, the way it was there in the earlier kalpa for each and every jiva. The jivatva bhava continues as long as avidya is there. As long as avidya is there, the sukshma sharira which is there in the bija avastha will be manifest with the same ingredients which went in across kalpas, therefore that will also be having pravaha nityattvam, anadikala. Anadikala parampara is there of all the samagris, and then avidya continuing, there will be adhyasa, because there will be samskara of earlier adhyasa, earlier janma also, and in this janma also there will be samskara of earlier adhyasa, and that will give rise to another adhyasa. Therefore adhyasya, mithuni kritya and loka vyavahara are all three different adhyasas having a dependency through the samskara, vyasana left behind, and therefore there is a purva para bhava. So tatra purva purva adhyasasya uttara uttara adhyasam prati samskara dvara purva kalatvena tvapratyaya usage is possible, thereby hetutva jyotanartham lyapah prayogah. There is hetu of the earlier adhyasa towards the later adhyasa via samskara being left. So that is the answer there. Tadeva spashteti naisargika iti, and that itself he is making clear by it is naisargika, meaning anadi. Naisargika there means it has always been there. Naisargika, nobody put an effort saying that I want an adhyasa. The adhyasa has been there, and samskara being there, automatically there is adhyasa, and that automatic adhyasa is what we call as naturally there is an adhyasa. Since birth there is an adhyasa in this janma, because earlier janma there is a samskara left of this adhyasa, that becomes a hetu for this adhyasa. Without one putting an effort, let alone an effort, without one knowing. Tika purva kalatvena iti, what is this purva kalaha yasya tatha? So purva kala is a bahuri, so that which has purva kala. The mithuni krutya word indicates an adhyasa, that adhyasa has another adhyasa which has a purva kala. So purva kala yasya adhyasasya sa adhyasa purva kala. So there is a purva kala adhyasa for the mithuni krutya kind of adhyasa. There is another adhyasa which is already there earlier and has left a samskara, which has been there and has left a samskara. Tasya bhava purva kalatvam. So tasya purva kalasya bhava purva kalatvam tatha. So that is tatha cha purva kala vrittitvena ichyartha. So with the purva kala vartana, there is an adhyasa earlier, there was an adhyasa earlier in time that has left a samskara, and that becomes the hetu for this samskara. Therefore there is a purva parabhava between the earlier and the later adhyasas, and so on with the loka vyavahara also, between mithuni krutya indicated adhyasa and the loka vyavahara indicated adhyasa, there is purva parabhava. Pratyagati ratna prabha प्रत्यगात्मनि हेतु हेतुमत् भाव भावेन अध्यास प्रवाह अनादि इत्यर्थः. सो व्हाट इज दिस नैसर्गिक, नैसर्गिक मींस अनादि अध्यास, इट हैज ऑलवेज बीन देयर, नॉट द सेम अध्यास. डेफिनेटली व्यक्ति भेद इज देयर, बट यू कैन नॉट से दैट अध्यास वाजंट देयर. सो अध्यास वाज ऑलवेज देयर, देयर वाज नेवर अ टाइम व्हेन अध्यास वाजंट देयर. देयरफॉर पूर्व काल कंटिन्यूज till what? There is no first kala. So it has ever been there. There is an anadi kala when adhyasa was there. So if you ask when was adhyasa there, adhyasa was there in anadi kala. It was always there so far. Now we don't know how we make use of this janma, and jnanena nivritti is possible. Adhyasa nivritti is possible only through jnana, because of avidya nivritti, avidya karya adhyasa nivritti will also take place. But until now it has been anadi. So pratyagatmani hetu hetu mat bhavena adhyasa pravaha, in one's own real self. So that is the pratyagatma, innermost self. In the pratyagatma there is an adhyasa pravaha continuing. So there is a flow, a chain of adhyasa, parampara of adhyasa. How? Hetu hetu mat bhavena. Earlier adhyasa becomes a hetu for the later adhyasa via samskara. Tika pratyagatmani adhyasa pravaha iti anvaya. So in pratyagatma there is an adhyasa pravaha. आत्मनि कर्तृत्व भोक्तृत्व दोष संबंध एव अध्यास. सो व्हाट इज द अध्यास हियर इन आत्मा? व्हेन यू से अध्यस्य मिथुनीकृत्य लोकव्यवहार, देर इज अ डिफरेंस इन व्हाट इज व्हाट इन टर्म्स ऑफ द थ्री अध्यासास, व्हाई थ्री आर टेकन. बट स्टिल कर्तृत्व भोक्तृत्व इटसेल्फ इज कर्तृत्व भोक्तृत्व संबंध. द कर्तृत्व इज अ दोष, कर्तृत्व इज अ दोष. Why is kartrutva dosha? Because if one considers oneself as a karta, meaning has an adhyasa of kartrutva in oneself, that kartrutva is a dosha because it will make the person bhokta also. If one considers oneself as karta, one cannot say that, no, I am not responsible. One has to be a bhokta also in this janma or in later janma. Therefore, bhoktrutva will be enforced. This bhoktrutva is enforced and this adhyasa is enforced by samskara. Because one will claim the results. I want the results of punya and one cannot escape the results of papa. Therefore, kartrutva bhoktrutva both are doshas. And atmani sambandha is there. In atma there is a sambandha. I am karta, aham karta, aham bhokta. Therefore, this dosha sambandha eva adhyasa. That itself is an adhyasa. Tadatmya sambandha. So that is an adhyasa. Atra vartamana bhoktrutva adhyasaha. कर्तृत्वाध्यासम अपेक्षते. नाउ वन इज अ भोक्ता. इन वन जन्म वन इज अ भोक्ता. इन दैट वेरी जन्म ही हैज डन समथिंग एंड इट इज आइडेंटिफाइबल. समटाइम्स इट इज नॉट. मेनी अ टाइम इट इज नॉट आइडेंटिफाइबल एज टू व्हाई आई एम गेटिंग दिस दुख. स्पेशली इन द दुख केस नोबडी क्वेश्चन यू नो हाउ आई गॉट दिस सुख. आई डोंट यू नो यू विन अ लॉटरी. Usually, I mean, oh, how I won a lottery, I don't know. I deserve this. You get a promotion, oh, I deserve this. But when there is a, you know, there is no raise or there is some dukkha, especially the mothers will talk about their child. So, you know, my child has done nothing, has never harmed even an ant. I don't know why he is facing such dukkha. Yeah, earlier janma dukkha is there, which is not visible to the child also, let alone the mother. What the person did does not know. What an animal did, that animal does not know why it has got this animal life. Similarly, humans also, we don't know why we got a particular life. Shastra say that our karma is so. Similarly, why a particular sukha dukha? Our karma is so. Can you identify the karma? No. In this janma, if you say, you can maybe associate with something, oh, I did something, there is a conscience which is within, that is hurting. It does not let me sleep. I did this. So someday I'll have this dukkha. And this is especially true in the, on the deathbed. Kimaham sadhuna karvam, kimaham papam karvam iti. So Taittiriya Upanishad says that this kind of a tapa will be there for a person who has some dharma, will inquire as to why I did all this, why I didn't do all this. Why didn't I do good? Why did I do bad? Because this will lead to dukkha. And exact thing cannot be known. Exact karma leading to exact dosha. I mean, in Shastra, in Jyotisha Shastra, someone may give a parihara, general one or a specific one, if it is known through the kundali. As to the horoscope says that such a papa has been done earlier. So grahas are arranged in such a manner that they show. This is how the person janma is, because this kind of a karma is there. So something may be visible, otherwise gahana karmano gatihi, says Gitacharya. Then bhoktrutvam is there. Why it is there? Because kartrutvam has been there earlier. Therefore atmani kartrutva bhoktrutva adhyasa is there. There atra vartamana bhoktrutva adhyasa. Bhoktrutva is an adhyasa because atma is not a bhokta, but I consider myself as a bhokta. Therefore, bhoktrutva dharma adhyasa is there. In the atma, vyatirekena, where it does not belong. Kartrutva adhyasam apekshate, that bhoktrutva adhyasa cannot be without the kartrutva being there earlier. So it has been there earlier. Kartrutva adhyasam apekshate means purva kalatvena apekshate. अपेक्षते ही हे ही एवार्थक. सो कर्तृत्व अध्यासम अपेक्षते अत्र वर्तमान भोक्तृत्वाध्यास कर्तृत्व अध्यासम अपेक्षते ही अकर्तृत्व अकर्तुर भोगा भावात व्हाई बिकॉज फॉर एन अकर्ता देर कैन नॉट बी भोगा समबडी हु हैज नॉट डन समथिंग विल नेवर गेट अ रिजल्ट विच इज ड्यू ओनली टू दैट काइंड ऑफ कर्म समबडी हैज नॉट डन दैट कर्म देर विल बी नो सच भोगा अदरवाइज ईश्वरा विल बिकम biased. Ishvara is not biased. Therefore, akartuhu bhoga bhavat is yetu. For an akarta, there will be no bhoga of that particular karma. Akarta of a particular karma, then that person will not have that kind of a bhoga. Therefore, there is a dependency of bhoktrutva adhyasa on kartrutva adhyasa. Definitely, there should be kartrutva of that particular karma if one is having that kind of a karma phala bhoga. कर्तृत्वं च रागद्वेष संबंध अध्यासम अपेक्षते नाउ कर्तृत्व हैज टू प्रीसीड भोक्तृत्व व्हाट अबाउट कर्तृत्व हाउ डिड दैट कर्तृत्व कम अप कर्तृत्व आल्सो हैज अ डिपेंडेंसी सो भोक्तृत्वम हैज अ डिपेंडेंसी ऑन कर्तृत्वम अर्लियर कर्तृत्वम हैज अ डिपेंडेंसी ऑन व्हाट व्हाट शुड हैव गॉन बाय अर्लियर पूर्व पूर्वभावी देयर शुड बी रागद्वेष विदाउट राग और द्वेष देयर विल बी नो कर्म So one becomes a karta of a particular karma because there is raga or dvesha. Some raga is there which makes person take up the action or even in giving up there is something. So raga dvesha sambandha adhyasam apekshate. So kartrutva has a dependency on raga dvesha sambandha. There will be some raga in the person or some dvesha. Thereby, there is a dependency on earlier ragadvesha for kartrutva and that kartrutva will lead to bhoktrutva. All these are adhyasas. Why so? Why should kartrutva have ragadvesha preceding, sambandha preceding? Ragadi raitasya kartrutva bhavat. Because one who does not have ragadvesha cannot have kartrutvam. So there is always so. Even in a jnani, if a jnani is serving the world in some way or the other. Bhagavan Bhashyakara brought up Bhashyas, he set up the Chaturamnaya Pithas. Did he have Raga? Yes. It may not be for oneself. There is nothing wrong in saying that there was Raga. There can be Shastriya Raga. So Kartrutva is there. Whether he had Kartrutva is a different story from his perspective. But from the onlooker's perspective, there is Kartrutva. Oh, he did all this, then there should be Kartrutva. Okay, if you say from your perspective there was Kartrutva, there is nothing wrong there. If Kartrutva is there, Ragadvesha was it there? Yes, Raga was there. What was the Raga for? Loka Vyavahara. For Loka Sangraha, Loka Sangraha Rupa Vyavahara, Karma has Loka Sangraha as Raga. So he wanted the society to improve, to follow Dharma. So Panchayatana Puja he set up Chaturamne Pita for Veda and Vedanta. So, Loka Vyavahara Drishti was there and by that you can consider Raga. No issues there. From the onlooker's perspective, there is no issue there. From his perspective, he may say that I was not a Karta. But, Prarabdha Vashat, things are getting done. As it was seen in Vichara Sagara towards the end. So, Prarabdha is there even for the Jnani. Jnani may not have a claim on that. But then he knows that Prarabdha, as long as Prarabdha is there, गुणागुणेषु वर्तन्ते एंड देयरफॉर इति मत्वा न सज्जते द ज्ञानी डज नॉट गेट कनेक्टेड टू इट बट देन थिंग्स गेट डन एंड देन ही गोज विद द फ्लो नंदलेस भोक्तृत्व हैज डिपेंडेंसी भोक्तृत्व अध्यास हैज डिपेंडेंसी ऑन कर्तृत्व अध्यास एंड कर्तृत्व अध्यास हैज डिपेंडेंसी ऑन राग द्वेष संबंध रूप अध्यास रागद्वेष संबंधश्च व्हाट अबाउट रागद्वेष संबंध वेर डिड दैट कम अप फ्रॉम रागद्वेष संबंधश्च पूर्वभोक्तृत्वम् अपेक्षते रागद्वेष इज बोर्न आउट ऑफ भोग इफ देयर इज सम अनुभव सम भोग देन दैट विल लीव एन इंप्रेशन लाइक अ स्टैंपिंग सो इन द स्टैंपिंग नॉट द यू नो पोस्टेज स्टैंप्स बट देन अर्लियर पोस्टेज स्टैंप्स इन द सेंस इफ अ दूता वुड कैरी अ मैसेज टू अनदर राजा Then the Raja would endorse the envelope with you know some kind of a material where he'll leave an impression of his ring. That ring is famous. He wears that ring or a particular symbol of the Rajya will be there. and they emboss that on the envelope seal, so that seal will show the impression. Similarly, this vasana is an impression left upon the antakkarana. Each and every bhoga will have that. Each and every bhoga will leave a vasana, a samskara. Therefore, ragadvesha, which is born out of samskara, is born out of bhoga, because samskara is born out of bhoga. Thereby, there is a dependence on earlier bhoga. So, ragadvesha, where did that come from? Ragadvesha sambandhascha puro bhoktrutvam apekshate. There should be earlier bhoktrutvam. One should have been a bhokta who had that kind of a bhoga leading to that kind of ragadvesha samskara, and therefore ragadvesha sambandha. Why so? Anupabhumte ragadyanupapattehe. You cannot have raga towards something or dvesha towards something that you don't have anubhava of. If you have not had bhoga of something, then you cannot like or dislike it. There are people who say that I like this, but I'm, or I don't like this, not having tasted. So something is served on the table, and then one says, oh, I don't want it. Why? For the looks, whatever may be the reason. Have you tasted it? No, I have never tasted it, but I don't want it. There is an earlier samskara why the person does not like it. Whether it is a bhranti is a different story. It can be a bhranti also. But there is something in the samskara which prods this person not to partake of that food. So there is some bhoktrutvam earlier, had similar experience or something else. So some bhoga is preceding. There is a dependency on that. Therefore, ragadvesha sambandha also has purva bhoktrutva apeksha. Now this bhoktrutva has a dependency of kartrutva. So then earlier bhoktrutvam, which gave rise to ragadvesha, has dependent on dependency on what now? So purva bhoktrutvam has a dependency on kartrutvam. Kartrutvam has a dependency on ragadvesha. Ragadvesha again has a dependency on purva bhoktrutvam, and thereby the parampara continues anadi kalena. Evam hetu hetu madbhavena pratyagatmani adhyasa pravaha anadiriti bhavaha. So this has already been there. This pravaha is there. Therefore, there is adhyasya mithunikritya. Mithunikritya is kartrutva. Kartrutva becomes what? There is kartrutva bhoktrutva bhava. Why so? Because earlier there has been adhyasa of the roop of the form of ragadvesha sambandha kartrutva, of the form of kartrutva. And then there is a phala roopa also, bhoga, samskara, that is also there. That phala will become hetu for another karya, which is an adhyasa as well. So there is a karana adhyasa, karya adhyasa, which is hetu for, and hetu hit. Hetumat. Hetumat is karya. Hetu is karana. So, evam hetu hetumat bhavena pratyagatmani. Unto atma, pratyagatma, adhyasa pravaha has always been there. Therefore, anadihi iti bhava. Pravaha, the flow of adhyasa, the parampara of adhyasa has been there forever. Up till now. So, sambandha rupasya pravahasya. Now this pravaha which is continuing, what is this pravaha? Adhyasa vyakti pravaha. Individual members, individual adhyasas are the members in this flow. So there is an adhyasa. What kind of adhyasa? Some adhyasa is there. Kartrutva adhyasa is there. Then bhoktrutva adhyasa is there. Then samskara being left behind, there is a ragadvesha rupa adhyasa. Then that will lead to kartrutva adhyasa, which is, there are different vyaktis. In the pravaha, there are many adhyasa vyaktis. So, sambandha rupasya pravahasya, this pravaha is in the form of sambandha between the purva and the uttara adhyasa, as shown earlier in the tika. Therefore, sambandha rupasya pravahasya sambandhi vyatirekena abhavat. This pravaha you are talking about, says the purva pakshi now. This anadi pravaha that you talk about, you said that adhyasa pravaha anadi. What is this adhyasa pravaha? It is a sambandha between the adhyasas. Individual vyakti adhyasa vyaktis are there, the sambandha between the earlier adhyasa and the later adhyasa, that itself is a pravaha. What else is a pravaha? Purvapakshi says, what is the pravaha? It isn't it sambandha between adhyasa vyaktis. So vyakti bheda, let it be there. You have answered my question as to how adhyasya adhyasya adhyasa. You said vyakti bhedat. Now I ask you, this pravaha is anadi. What is this pravaha? It is an adhyasa sambandha, purva parabhava, between adhyasa vyaktis. What are these adhyasa vyaktis? Samskara will come and go away. Raga dvesha will come and go away. Kartrutva bhava will come and go away. You know, you are a karta of a particular karma, then you are a karta of another karma, then yet another karma. So that kartrutva bhava also, you are a karta of a particular karma, you may need not be a karta of all karmas. So the karta came and went in a particular kriya. Bhukta also came and went with a karma, particular karma phala. So vyakti bheda, adhyasa bheda is there. Adhyasa comes and goes. Kartrutva adhyasa came in and went. If nothing, you will say that, okay, I am a kartra throughout the day, but in the deep sleep, in Shushupti avastha, are you a karta? You are not a karta. So at least that much you have to accept, that adhyasa continues throughout the day. Although Vedanti does not say that adhyasa continues through the day, as in the same adhyasa. Of course, broader adhyasa is there. I am this person. That adhyasa may be there, but there are so many adhyasas. One vyakti having the dependency on another earlier adhyasa vyakti, there is a parampara pravaha which is sambandha rupa. Therefore, sambandha rupasya pravahasya, adhyasa pravahasya, sambandhi, who is the sambandhi? Sambandha asya asya iti sambandhi. So, pravaha is sambandha rupa and sambandhi is what? The vyakti. The pravaha asya asti iti pravahi. Who is the pravahi? Sambandha asya asti iti sambandhi. Matuparthe ini. So this sambandhi is the vyakti. Who is that vyakti? Vanadhyasa, kartrutva adhyasa, bhoktrutva adhyasa, ragadvesha adhyasa. All these adhyasas that you have talked about earlier, you have explained the chain very beautifully. But by expressing that there is vyakti bheda, you say that adhyasas have been there. Therefore, I can talk about lapratya, purva parabhava. Now, purva parabhava shows you these adhyasa vyaktis have a beginning and an end. So, adhyasa comes up and goes. Another adhyasa comes up and goes. Therefore, sambandhi vyatirekena pravahasya abhavat. This sambandha can be there only when sambandhi is there. Although the vyutpatti of sambandhi is sambandha asya asti sambandhi, pravahasya asti pravahi, still this pravaha has no presence without the pravahi, meaning the sambandha has no presence without the sambandhi. In Vyakrana you will say sambandhi is one who has sambandha, but here you can't use that. What is the pravaha? Pravahi sambandha rupa, sambandha between vyaktis. Without the vyaktis you cannot have sambandha between the vyaktis. Therefore, without the individual adhyasas, you cannot have pravaha of adhyasas. And pravaha you are claiming as anadi, whereas vyaktis are adimat. Vyaktis have an adi and an anta. Therefore, vyaktis having adi and anta and pravaha cannot be without the vyaktis. There is nothing called as a pravaha without these vyaktis. In fact, this is something which is discussed by the Karikakara. Bhagavan Gaudapadacharya in Mandukya Karika talks about this pravaha. He says this hetu hetumat bhava, and there the hetu hetumat, just a detour to explain how valid is this objection. It is a very valid objection, because in Mandukya Karika, the Siddhanti raises this objection towards the Purvapakshi. Who is the Purvapakshi? Who says there is samsara, there is karma and phala. So karma phala have hetu hetumat bhava, and one karma phala leads to more karma, the karma leads to another similar case here. Here we are talking about adhyasa. There is a real sambandha, real pravaha of hetu hetumat bhava by Bijankuranyaya has been taken up, and then Bhagavan Gaudapadacharya refutes it with the same logic. because there is nothing called as a pravaha without the individual members are mithya, then this your pravaha is mithya, and thereby ajatavada, there is no janma, there is ajatavada. So back in the context, this is a very valid objection as to there cannot be anadi pravaha when the members themselves are adimat. Therefore sambandhi vyatirekena pravaha sambandha rupasya pravahasya abhavat sambandhi swarupanam adhyasa vyaktinam tu sadhitvaccha. They are sadhi, adimat. Sadhi means adimat itself. So adina sa vartate iti sadhi. So the vyaktis, adhyasa vyaktis, individual adhyasas are sambandhi swarupa. Sambandhi swarupanam adhyasa vyaktinam tu sadhitvaccha. Since pravaha cannot exist without the members, and the members are not anadi, they are sadhi, therefore your pravaha is not possible to be anadi. Therefore na anadityam kasya pravasya, pravasya anadityam nasti iti akshepa. This is the purvapakshi nanu iti. Ratnaprabha, nanu pravahasya avastutvat adhyasa vyaktinam sadhitvat katam anadityam iti chet uchyate. So the same objection which was detailed in the tika as an introduction to this in the Ratnaprabha. So what is the question? Pravahasya avastutva. There is nothing called as pravaha without the vyaktis. Adhyasa pravaha is not there. There is nothing called as adhyasa pravaha other than adhyasa vyaktis, who have sambandha, of course. Therefore, adhyasa vyakti naam sadhitvat. Adhyasa vyakti, since adhyasa vyaktis are having, individual adhyasas are having a beginning, how can you say pravaha, which is nothing but the sambandha between these adhyasa vyaktis, that pravaha to be anadi? How can it be? There is nothing called as pravaha. It is just a name given to series of sadhi adhyasas. How can pravaha be anadi when individuals are sadhi? Katham anadityam iti ched uchyate. So uchyate will tell you, says the siddhanti. Tika nanu iti anadi kalatva nishta vyapyata nirupita vyapakata avachedaka avachinna sambandha pratiyogitvam anadi kalatva vyapaka sambandha pratiyogitvam karya anadityam iti siddhante iti. So it's too complex to go into this. So we'll skip this. What is being said, I'll explain. We'll not get into detailed word analysis. So there is a vyapyata rupa, vyapyata nirupita vyapakata sambandha. So there is a vyapya vyapaka bhava between the adhyasas and the kala which has been anadi. The kala is anadi, meaning anadi kalatva nishta. In anadi kala, what is there? There is a vyapyata vyapaka rupa sambandha of these adhyasas, which is there with the kalika sambandha, it is there, and kala is anadi. Kala has been continuing. And what is this anadi kala? Kala is anadi in the sense the adhyasa, with the perspective of adhyasa, kala is anadi. There was never a time when adhyasa wasn't there. This adhyasa, we are not saying that particular vyakti is there, particular adhyasa is there, but some adhyasa was there. Therefore there was never a kala. Kala has always been continuing, and in no kala was there a lack of adhyasa. Adhyasa was always there. Therefore, anadi kalatva nishta. Vyapyata nirupita vyapakata avachedaka avachinna sambandha pratiyogitvam. So that kind of pratiyogitvam, meaning there is never an abhava of adhyasa in kala. Which kala? Any kala you take. So you take any kala, in anadi kala, there was never an abhava of adhyasa in that kala. By kalika sambandha, if you take, then there was never an abhava. Now, that is the anadi kalatva vyapaka sambandha pratiyogitvam, and that is called as karya anadityam. So, karya anadityam, karya here is adhyasa. This adhyasa karya of earlier adhyasa. So, one adhyasa is karana for another adhyasa. You explained the hetu hetuvat bhava. The siddhanti says we explained the hetu hetuvat bhava. So that objection that you are talking about as to sambandha between the two is a pravaha cannot be anadi because vyaktis are anadi. What we mean is that there was never a kala that adhyasa wasn't there. So adhyasa abhava pratiyogi adhyasa the adhyasa this adhyasa was always having another adhyasa as hetu. Therefore there was never a kala where there was adhyasa abhava. Meaning adhyasa was ever there. Therefore karya itself, which is adhyasa, is figuratively talked about as anadi. It is not the same adhyasa which is anadi, but the karya adhyasa is said to be anadi because karana itself has led to this, and that karana was also adhyasa, and therefore adhyasa chain can be said to be anadi. That is the idea with this long technical nayayika language. It's a navanayayika language in which this is expressed. So siddhanti, so he says that this is our siddhanta uchyate iti in the Ratna Prabha. Adhyasatva avachinna vyaktina madhye anyatamaya vyaktya vina anadikalasya avartanam karyanaditvam iti angikara. So what is accepted in siddhanta, advaita siddhanta, he says adhyasatva avachinna vyaktina. These individual vyaktis make up the pravahava. I do agree, Siddhanti says. So these vyaktis, individual adhyasas are what? They are adhyasatva avachinna. Meaning, adhyasatva avachinna means all adhyasas. Yavad adhyasa. So yavad adhyasa, each and every adhyasa you take, which is a vyakti in this pravaha that I am claiming to be anadi, vyakti. Each vyakti, which vyakti, any vyakti you take in any kala, that was adhyasatva avachinna. That adhyasa, vyakti is adhyasatva avachinna. Among all the adhyasas, anyatamaya vyaktya. Anyatamaya means one among many. So, one among all adhyasas, many adhyasas, which have taken place so far, each among all the individual adhyasas which have taken place so far, vyaktyavina, anyatamaya vyaktyavina, without a single vyakti, anadikalasya avartanam karya anadityam. Anadikala cannot be there. Meaning, there is no vyaktyavina, anyatamaya vyaktyavina. In this, so many adhyasas which have taken place so far, there is no kala. Kalasya avartanam. What kala? You take any kala, so anadi kala. You take any kala at any point of time, you cannot claim that there was ever a kala. Vartanam wasn't there, meaning avartanam was there. There was, you cannot talk about any kala when there was no adhyasa vyakti. So anyatamaya vyaktya, anyatamaya vyakti, vyakti is adhyasa. So individual, at least one of the adhyasa vyaktis was there in any kala that you pick. Therefore, anyatamaya vyaktya adhyasena vina anadi kalasya avartanam. There was never a kala without some adhyasa among so many adhyasas that have gone by. Which are those? Adhyasatva avachinna vyakti. Therefore, that itself is called as, accepted as angikarat karya anaritvam. That is called as karya anaritvam. Because adhyasa, some adhyasa or the other was there in some kala, therefore adhyasa, which is karya, itself is called as what? It is avidya karya. It is an adhyasa, purva adhyasa left samskara karya, which is actually continuing because of avidya. So this is karya adhyasa, which has always been there because in every kala there was some adhyasa or the other. Etena karana, we'll come back to this tika. Karya adhyasasya pravaha rupena anaditvam vyatireka mukhena avishkaroti. So this karya adhyasasya pravaha rupena anaditvam. How is this anaditvam? Earlier one is mentioned, the connection. Now, this pravaha rupena anadityam katham karyadhyasasya. व्यतिरेक मुखेन आविष्करोति अध्यासत्वे इति अध्यासत्वावच्छिन्न व्यक्तिनाम इत्यादि विच वी लुक्ड एट. सो बाय टॉकिंग अबाउट काला देयर वाज नेवर अ काला विच हैड नो अध्यास देयरफॉर दैट कार्य इन दैट पर्टिकुलर अध्यास कार्य इन दैट पर्टिकुलर काला इज आल्सो अनादि फिगरेटिवली. यत्र अनादिकालत्वं तत्र अध्यासत्वावच्छिन्न अध्यास व्यक्ति संबंध इति व्याप्य व्यापक भाव अनुभव सिद्ध. सो द व्याप्य व्यापक भाव विच वॉज मेन्शनड अर्लियर विद दि निष्कृष्ट सेंटेन्स देर इज एक्सप्लेन हियर एज यत्र अनादिकालत्वं वेर एवर देर वॉज अनादिकालत्वं वेर देर इन एवरी काला देर इज सम मोमेंट ऑफ टाइम इन दैट एनी पिक टाइम यू पिक तत्र अध्यासत्वावच्छिन्न अध्यास व्यक्ति संबंधः देयर वाज ऑलवेज अ पर्टिकुलर अध्यास विच इज कार्य ऑफ एन अर्लियर अध्यास देयरफॉर दैट संबंध वाज देयर विद द अर्लियर कारण अध्यास देयर वाज ऑलवेज अ संबंध ऑफ दिस कार्य अध्यास एट एनी पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम एंड दैट संबंध इज अनादि बिकॉज संबंध हैज ऑलवेज बीन देयर कार्य अध्यास हैज ऑलवेज हैड संबंध विद कारण अध्यास and therefore in any time any period of time you take there was always this sambandha and that sambandha can be called as anadi. Now karya, that is karya anaditva, adhyasa is anadi because pravaha is anadi, and what is pravaha? Pravaha is a sambandha between the vyaktis, karana adhyasa and karya adhyasa, and that was always there between karana and karya. Therefore yatra anadi kalatvam tatra adhyasatva avachinna adhyasa vyakti sambandha iti व्याप्य व्यापक भाव अनुभव सिद्ध. इट इज क्लियरली अनुभव सिद्ध लाइक बीजांकुर व्यक्ति संबंधो नाम व्यक्ति प्रतियोग का संबंध तथा च संबंध प्रतियोगित्वं व्यक्तौ वर्तते इति लक्ष्ये लक्षण समन्वय. सो हाउ डू यू कॉल दिस एज अध्यास इज अनादि बिकॉज संबंध प्रतियोगित्वं व्यक्तौ वर्तते. दिस संबंध प्रतियोगित्वं इज देयर. You can talk about the sambandha, and that kind of an individual adhyasa is there because every adhyasa has the sambandha with the earlier karana adhyasa. Iti lakshe lakshana samanvaya. This is how the anadityam can be shown in of this adhyasa. Shushuptyadav kartrutvadhyadhyasa bhavi api tat samskar sattvatna vyaptir vyabhicharaha. Now this vyapti, यत्र अनादिकालत्वं तत्र अध्यासत्वावच्छिन्न अध्यास व्यक्ति संबंध. सो देयर इज अ संबंध विच कारण ऑफ द कार्य. द कार्य इज अध्यास बट कारण इज ऑल्सो अध्यास. देयरफॉर अध्यासत्वावच्छिन्न तत्र अध्यासत्वावच्छिन्न अध्यास व्यक्ति संबंध. देयर इज एन अध्यास व्यक्ति संबंध. अर्लियर अध्यास व्यक्ति संबंध इज देयर इन दिस अध्यास कार्य अध्यास. And what is that karana, earlier one? That is also adhyasa. Why? Because adhyasatva avachinna. So this is the vyapti there. Yatra anadi kalatvam tatra adhyasatva avachinna adhyasa vyakti sambandha. So there is a vyapya vyapaka bhava. Vyapti is there. Now, shushuptyadu kartrutvadya adhyasa bhava api. So the Purvapakshi brings in a question there. I'll stop after this. I've gone beyond time. But shushuptyadu, in shushupti or in coma, etc., or in after marana, is there adhyasa at the, in that kala, in shushupti kala, in mrityu kala? This can be an objection. In coma kala, kartrutva adhyadhyasa bhavepi. No, there is no kartrutva. Let's say bhoktrutva can be questioned, so we will not discuss about that. But kartrutva adhi, at least kartrutva adhyasa isn't there. You said that there is a series. So Purvapakshi says, in shushupti where is the kartrutvam? You tell me. There is no kartrutva adhyasa. So although there is no kartrutva adhyasa, kartrutva adhyasa abhavyapi, kada sushupti adu, in sushupti etc., then in deep sleep, if kartrutva adhyasa isn't there, even if it isn't there, tat samskaratvat na vyaptir vyavichar. Samskara is there. We are saying that there is karana karya bhava, hetu hetu mat bhava. It need not be direct. There is a samskara. So purva adhyasa, कर्तृत्व अध्यास संस्कार इज देयर, भोक्तृत्व अध्यास संस्कार इज देयर, एंड ऑल्सो संस्कार ऑफ राग द्वेष इत्यादि अध्यास. देयरफॉर तत् संस्कार सत्वात् न व्याप्तेर व्यभिचार. अदरवाइज वन विल नेवर वेक अप टू बी अ कर्ता. देयर इज बीज ऑफ कर्तृत्व इन इन सुषुप्ति अवस्था. देयरफॉर अज्ञानी वेक्स अप एज एन अज्ञानी, ज्ञानी वेक्स अप एज अ ज्ञानी. सुषुप्ति मेक्स नो डिफरेंस देयर. సో ప్రవాహ నిత్యత్వం కంటిన్యూస్, ప్రవాహ కంటిన్యూస్, అనాదికాల ప్రవాహ కంటిన్యూస్, దేర్ ఫోర్ వ్యాప్తే వ్యభిచార న, దెర్ ఇస్ నో వ్యభిచార ఇన్ దిస్, వ్యాప్తి ఇది భావ. Vikalpaha Tritiya Ityartha. Now, this topic is over. What is the topic? The discussion came up in the topic of the second option created there as to, there were three options created as to what is this, as to Adhyasa not being possible. Is Adhyasa not possible because it is illogical or there is no Bhana? So first Ishtapatti, yeah, it is illogical, it shouldn't be there, but it is there. Therefore, na bhavitum arhati. So adhyasa mithya, no not na, adhyasa bhavitum, mithya bhavitum arhati, mithya means na, adhyasa nasti. Nasti iti bhavitum arhati, mithya iti bhavitum arhati, nasti iti bhavitum arhati. There itself Bhagavan Bhashyakara has said that we agree with it. It shouldn't be there, but it is there. So is it illogical? Yes, it is illogical. But is it there? Yes, anubhava siddha. So shouldn't be there, it should be there. So why is adhyasa not there? Puro Pakshi was questioned. Is it because it is illogical? He says, yeah, it is illogical. Okay, it is illogical, but ishtapatti. But anubhava siddha, it is there, you have to accept it. Then abhanadva. So anubhava siddha was said there. Aham manushya, aham ajnya, aham karta. All these ideas are there. Therefore, not the second option also. Second option was abhanadva. The third option is what? Karana bhavadva. Third option is without karana. That has been answered now. Etena karana bhavad iti kalpa, kalpa vikalpaha nirastaha. So this topic of the third type, karana, adhyasa karana is not there. Therefore adhyasa is not possible. This was the third possibility that Puro Pakshi may have mentioned. And there, Vikalpa Tritiya Paksha Ityartha. So Kalpa Tritiya, the third objection to Adhyasa not being possible because there is no Karana, that has been refuted by showing Karana is there. Hetu Hetu Madbha Pravaha, Adhyasa Pravaha is there. Anadikala, that itself is Karana for Adhyasa to be possible. Therefore Vikalpa Tritiya Paksha Ityartha. We'll look at more in the next part. यम ह्य कारुणिकं शरणं गतोऽप्यरि सहो आप महत्पदं तमहमाशु हरिं परमाश्रये जनकजाङ्कमनन्त सुखाकृतिं. नमस्ते, एनी क्वेश्चंस? नेक्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ